myself there.
It is my pleasure to welcome you. To the Edward A. Crown Scholarship Dinner. I am Noah Pinchot. Thank you. I wanted to know if each of you feel the same adrenaline rush that I do every time I step foot in this remarkable new building. I truly hope that that sensation and that appreciation never fades. Your support of our annual campaign and participation this evening allows us to allocate crucial dollars to the scholarship fund so that every child can experience the academy. Thank you to all of the Society of Patron members who are listed in the program for your partnership in making this evening and the school a success. Thank you to our dinner co-chairs, Andrea Metzel, Allison and Alan Malotsky, Lori Pinchot and her husband, and Michelle and Randy Trubnik, and the entire dinner tribute committee who are listed in your programs. Thank you to Tammy Sugar, Development Chair, and to our Society of Patron Chairs, Daniela Jacques-Litzberg, and Sue and David Strelowitz. We are also grateful to Pam Braun, Deborah Sorscher, our Ad Journal Chairs, Michelle Trubnik, and Regina Vogel, Ad Sales Chairs, and Eliza Frank and Mari Gorenstein, our Auction Chairs. And by the way, there is still time to place your bids on silent auction items and buy your raffle tickets. We will be announcing the closing of the auction shortly after the dinner is served. A special welcome to a great friend of the Academy, Donna Kahn, and Jordan Amrani, and Zivia Feifel, who are representing JUF this evening. We thank the Federation for its 2017 allocation to Ida Crown of over $432,000. And we thank the Jewish Day School Guarantee Trust Fund donors, this year $1.7 million. Are being distributed by the Guarantee Trust, of which ICJA is receiving over $100,000. I also want to thank all of the faculty, staff, and administration of the Academy who invest countless hours and dedicate their lives to our children. Would all members of the Academy's teaching, staff, and administrative team please rise so we can show our appreciation. Finally, I would like to take a moment to remember Rabbi Norman Goldberg, who served as our assistant principal for many years and who passed away this past year. Rabbi Goldberg was a beloved member of our academy administration, and we will miss him dearly. We also note that this evening, a profound mother and grandmother in the ICJA family, Mrs. Marilyn Allswang Eisenberg, was scheduled to join us. We extend our condolences to her extended family who are sitting shiva for her this week. Please rise now for the Star Spangled Banner and Hatikvah led by the Ida Crown Band. Thank you.
So let's talk about inspiration. Faulkner says literature serves as a pillar to help you endure and prevail. And that's what I'm hoping that we do for the students. We do that through literature, we do that through Torah, we do that through interaction, we do that through being ICJA.
Yeah, you can be the greatest, you can be the best, you can be the King Kong banging on your chest.
You can beat the world, you can beat the war, you can talk to God, go banging on his door.
All of the programs that we run give our students the opportunity to learn and to talk and make the text come alive so that what they're learning in my classroom is not just a book, but it's something that they're going to take with them.
I'm in Mrs. Aaron's 10th grade honors English class, and this year we focus a lot on critical thinking to find different parts of myself and look at the world in a really different way.
One of my favorite things is the basketball team. We learn different skills like teamwork and become almost like a family. Those are the kind of things that are going to help me build relationships when I leave Idaho.
Yeah, you can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock, yeah. You can move a mountain, you can break rocks.
I'm involved in B'nai Kiva. One of the things we recently did was raise money for the people that were affected by the recent fires in Israel. Doing things like this really helped me develop a connection between what I'm doing in high school and what I can do after high school.
I'm taking a new class at Ida Crown this year called AP Computer Science. We spend so much of our day on all these devices, and what this class teaches you is the code behind it, and I find that so interesting.
I'm an Honors Girls Gemara with Rabbi Matinki, which means I have the incredible opportunity to learn with a national leader and to build a relationship with him that's really going to be with me for life. The class also helps me gain a familiarity with the language of the Gemara and Hebrew.
I believe with all of my heart that what takes place in this building transforms our community. Our tagline is real. We want our students to thrive in the modern world and show the best that we can be.
Inspiring B'nai and B'not Torah to thrive in the modern world.
Inspiring B'nai and B'not Torah to thrive in the modern world.
Inspiring B'nai and B'not Torah to thrive in the modern world.
Inspiration. Isn't that what we all strive to achieve in our lives? Because inspiration is the secret to a successful life and a life of meaning, which is what the Ida Crown Jewish Academy is all about. It's about inspiring the next generation of Jewish leaders, and it's about inspiring young men and women to go into the world and make a difference. And it's about, as our vision statement proclaims so proudly, inspiring B'nai and B'not Torah to thrive in the modern world. And the way we do this is not merely by offering more than 250 sections of classes each and every day, and not simply by supporting the learning needs of all of our students so successfully that the average ACT score of this year's graduating class is 28. And not only by offering 14 APs, 4 STEM courses, a full sequence of conceptual courses for weaker students, creating partnerships with Northwestern University, the Jewish New Teacher Project, Yad Vashem, Bar Ilan, the YU Kollel in Keshet, and not even by having more than 30 clubs, 12 interscholastic sports teams, one of which our girls' varsity basketball team was recognized today by the WNBA as Chicago Sky's weekly winner of the 2017 High School Team of the Week. And not only with all of the Shabbatonim, Yemei Yul, Kumsa team, and not even by the 85% of our graduates spending their gap year studying in yeshivot, seminaries, serving in Tzahal in the state of Israel. Rather, the way we inspire our students is by creating relationships, as you'll hear about when we celebrate the career and accomplishments of our Teacher of the Year, Ms. Susan Sennett. A person who lives the lesson that nobody cares how much you know until they know how much you care. And we inspire our students by setting the bar high and showing them that they can succeed. Something that we will celebrate as we remember the life lessons of our dear departed friend, Dr. Tammy Kaplan, alayha shalom, and dedicate our college guidance department in her memory. Because a meaningful life is a life not only of success, but of continued growth. And we inspire our students by teaching them values. Values that transcend the text, but values that are firmly based within the text. Because it is those values, the values of Torah u'Madab, of engagement and creativity, that draw people to our school and that we celebrate through this year's honorees, Parents of the Year, Steve and Julie Grant. And we inspire our students by showing them that they are part of something bigger and something greater, that they are, as the Midrash teaches, a letter in the scroll of Torah, a connection to the past and the hope for our future, which we celebrate through George and Julie Lennon, alumni.
He doesn't mean it.
Alumni whose parents and grandparents were founders of our community and whose children and grandchildren represent the best of our future. We strive to inspire our students each and every day by providing a setting and an opportunity, by celebrating our students, our teachers, and all of their accomplishments. The late Ambassador Yehuda Avner, alav shalom, in his book, The Prime Ministers, told the story of a meeting he had once with the late Lubavitcher Rebbe Zatzal. Said the Rebbe to Avner, Rebbe Yehuda, let me tell you what I try to do. Imagine you're looking at a candle. What you're really seeing is a mere lump of wax with a thread down its middle. So when do the thread and the wax become a candle? When do they fulfill the purpose for which they were created? When you put a flame to that thread. It is then that the wax and the thread become a candle. Added the Rebbe, the wax, Rebbe Yehuda, is the body, and the wick is the soul. Bring the flame of Torah to the soul, then the body will fulfill the purpose for which it was created. And that is what I try to do, to ignite the soul of every Jew with the fire of Torah, with the passion of our tradition and with the sanctity of our heritage, so that each individual will fulfill the real purpose for which he or she was created. A little while later, as Ambassador Avner turned one more time to the Rebbe, he asked, has the Rebbe lit my candle? No, he said, clasping Avner's hand, I've given you the match. Only you can light your own candle. Ladies and gentlemen, for 74 years, we and those who came before us have worked tirelessly, not only to pass the candle forward, but to inspire our students to take the match and bring forth the light. Tonight, I thank you for joining us as we celebrate the light and the inspiration and the accomplishments of Ms. Sennett, of the Lennons, the Grants, and the late Dr. Tammy Kaplan. But we need your help to keep the candle burning. We need your children and your grandchildren to come to the Ida Crown Jewish Academy. We need your friendship and we need your encouragement in our community, sharing with them the amazing things that we do. And yes, we also need your financial support to help fund scholarships for over 65% of our families who are in need. For while I'm proud to announce that this evening we have raised so far $965,000 towards our scholarship campaign. We still need to be able to reach our goal, an additional $222,000. And so we do need your support. And so if you've already given to the scholarship campaign, thank you so very much. But please, consider an increase this year. And if you haven't, I'll be waiting at the door while you leave. Because we really do need your help. We need your help so that next year, and the year after, and the year after that, we will ignite the soul of every one of our students with the fire of Torah, so that we will celebrate together the achievement of inspiring B'nai and B'not Torah to thrive in the modern world. Ladies and gentlemen, we need you. Thank you for coming.
I was a practicing attorney, and sitting behind a desk 5 or 6 days a week was just unappealing to me. I love the law, but the practice of law as a business was not something I enjoyed or really wanted to go back to. So never having really done it before in high school, I got a job here as, shall we call it, a 3-year experiment. And well, I figured things out and it became a 23-year love affair with the Academy and teaching history and art history, which are my passions and my areas of interest. The Academy has had a huge impact on my life. It has given my life purpose. I enjoy coming to work. People say, like, how can you do something for 20 years and still get excited about it? And year after year, the students have never let me down. Because that's really what it is. It's the students. They are what make the Academy such a wonderful place to work. This is the only place where you hand someone a test and they go, thank you, like you're doing them a favor.
What's really very special about Susan Sennett is her enthusiasm for the art of teaching and her knowledge of her content. She knows the history, but she loves the history. And it's not just about dates and names and places, but what everything meant. You really make it alive. And students feel it and they see it.
They're so excited when they come in and they're ready to learn, and she knows how to engage them. One of her best projects that I absolutely adore is her shield project, where when they get to feudalism, she has the students then create their own shields, and that taps into both the artistic element, and then they have to write an essay explaining the choices that they did.
I've never seen a class taught like hers. She makes everything fun while teaching at the same time.
I think the students feel special in Susan's class. They feel that she's an expert, but that she still cares about each of them.
Just you could tell when she was teaching that she was excited about what she was telling you, not just reading facts from a textbook. She really knows what she's talking about and she really enjoys it. And that just made it more enjoyable for me.
That personal relationship she has. Whenever someone comes in and asks a question, she sits down, she makes sure that they've understood anything she has to tell them.
She really looks out for the students, so she makes sure that you understand the material and that she's available if you need any help.
It really shows that she's not just about, okay, this is my job, and you know, when it's over, when you graduate, goodbye. We go for dinner about twice a year, and it's just really cool to see like that she's still invested in my life even 12 years after I've graduated. We felt like she cared about us, and it caused us to want to succeed in class.
You know, everybody knows Miss Sennett. She has her own Sennettopia, where she creates her own environment in her classroom. She knows how to teach democracy by modeling democracy, not just telling, but showing and getting kids involved. And they flock to her.
I love being here. It brightens my life. When I was practicing law, there were often weeks where by Wednesday I was already like, isn't it Friday yet? At the Academy, even after all of these years, I'm still smiling on Friday afternoon. The whole Academy, both the students and the people I work with and the administration, are like a community. It's a wonderful feeling to come to work and feel like you're a part of something, and I think that's important. I think it's given me a certain amount of confidence, a feeling that I'm making a difference in the world. I have students who come back 10 years after they've graduated and tell me I made a difference. That's a tremendous feeling that you made a difference in somebody else's life.
Other people. The award reads Miss Susan Sennett, Educator of the Year Award, Dr. Edward A. Crown Scholarship Dinner, Ida Crown Jewish Academy. Proud, and to every parent sitting out there in the audience, thank you so much for sharing your children. It is a privilege to teach them, and I mean that from the bottom of my heart. Thank you.
My kids were little, we just kept running into people, parents of our kids' friends, people we would meet at shul, all kinds of different walks of life, and inevitably you would come to these moments where people would say, yeah, I went to the Academy, I went to Ida Crown, and after a while it started to stick out that these were accomplished, dignified people, and as a parent you started to get the idea in your head that, geez, I want my kids to be like these people.
There's a real purposeful consciousness about teaching certain values, like respect, and I have seen through the years with our kids that it's borne fruit, you know, that they seem to have internalized some of those things that fit with what the kind of values we want them to have.
I remember that first visit. We met Rivka. She took us to Rabbi Gutstein's Samara class. We walk into this class, and like that, all these girls just stand up. I don't think anyone's ever stood up for me, okay? It hit me right from the get-go.
We're in a unique position because we're the outsiders in a way, both because we didn't come up through Hillel Torah and because we don't live near most of the people that go here. So we have been just so warmly welcomed and included and hosted, and I mean, it's just been amazing.
I remember my first interview with Steve and Julie. They told me what it meant to them to have decided to send their children to the academy. The distance they were willing to travel to be able to come here, and the distance also in terms of community. But they have traversed those distances with great skill and style, and they have raised a family and created a family that is l'shem u'l'tiferet, that is glorious and wonderful and represents everything that we're so proud of.
Both she and Steve, I think, are summed up by the Hebrew word chayin, some combination of genuineness, kindness, and just exuberance about life. And I think that anyone who meets them sees that quality right away, and people are drawn to that.
Well, I think the Grants just value compassion in people, treating people the right way. And I think having the Jewish overlay to really their natural predisposition,
right,
it's just who they are.
My parents really embody that vision for Torah Umada that the Academy works so hard to promote. This true, genuine care for how we approach our secular studies, combined with a passion for Judaism that pushes them to facilitate this growth with living vibrant Jewish lives.
Even my dad, when he's stressed out about work, I feel like he's always pushing to be better, to create something good. And my mom, I feel like, just is constantly looking for more ways to reach her potential. She'll take a painting class, or she'll start writing, or she'll do all these different things, and I feel like they're both searching and growing in positive ways.
There's a reason that our parents sent us here, and it's because Ida Crown continues to teach us the values that they already have.
I would say a remarkable thing about the Grants is when you look at their kids. It's how well they fit in with the social fabric of the school when they're here. And then if you look at them when they've graduated, it's a thing that they've gone on to do afterwards. In many ways, they really are model students. And I think as parents, that's about as good as it gets.
Their dedication to their kids' emotional, physical, and spiritual well-being is really their top priority in their lives.
Steve and Julie Grant are parents of the year for the simple reason that they made a very tough decision to send their children to the academy. And they've supported the academy every step of the way, and they have reared children for whom we are so proud, and they gain so much nachas.
Like Rabbi Matanki says, you know, he's got our kids more than we do. And when you look at the people they're with from period to period to period, I just didn't have a frame of reference for that.
Warmth and connection are two things that have been a really kind of wonderful experience, you know, that we've had here. Just feels like people really care about each other and all want the same thing, which is for their kids to grow up happy and healthy and sensitive to others and, you know, good people.
And now we see it on the backside. My son, you know, he's in an engineering program where there's kids from, you know, every corner of the world. And it almost seems like he's better prepared to integrate with all these different kinds of people.
You know, there was people all of one faith here, but as a representation of that faith, what was taught was a certain way of being in the world. And hopefully they'll continue to carry that forward.
It's just been a great experience for us.
We'd like to present this award to
Julie and Steve Grant, mom and dad, parents of the year, Dr. Edward A. Crown Scholarship Dinner, Ida Crown Jewish Academy, February 22nd, 2017, the 27th of Shvat, 5777. We love you.
Flattered to be here tonight. It is a distinct honor to be on the program with the Lennons, Ms. Sennett, and Dr. Kaplan of blessed memory. We'd like to thank all of our family and friends who are here tonight and everyone who pitched in to help the scholarship fund. Our guess is that the Parents of the Year Award does not have formal selection criteria. But if it's only an award for enthusiasm, we probably qualify. We just fundamentally appreciate the mission of this school. Today's world seems so obsessed with speed, so much focus on the now. Yet our school has this foundation in an ageless tradition combined with a long-term future tense point of view, inspiring B'nai and B'not Torah to thrive, both present and future. This just seems right to us. And we feel extremely blessed that our children are a part of that mission and that we as parents have been able to go along for the ride. Thank you.
Apparently, I got so excited about the Lori Pinchot husband joke I skipped one line in my prepared remarks. So let me say this again. I wanted to thank our dinner co-chairs, Hinda and Frank Rubin, Barbara and Steve Geller, Andrea Metzel, Allison and Alan Malotsky, Lori Pinchot and her husband, and Michelle and Randy Trubick. I would like to strongly encourage everyone here to participate in the auction and raffle at this time. It is a fundamental aspect of the fundraising and development this evening. And now I would like to announce that dinner is served. Thank you.
George, where did they live?
Barbara and I want to thank the Academy for voting us Alumni of the Year. Thanks a lot.
This is for Julie and George, Jan.
Julie and George? I don't believe it. You mean they've actually graduated the Academy? They can't possibly be.
Are they ready for this?
I think the Academy has a very important place in the community as a school that represents our values as centrist, modern Orthodox Jews living in this world with a strong emphasis on Zionism.
I think tolerance is such a key ingredient because as you go out into the world, you're meeting with people with diverse opinions, and the Academy teaches you how to deal with that and to embrace it.
You know, it's a warm place. It's that type of place that you walk in and people know you and they know where you came from and they know your kids and they know your, you know, extended family. It's a nice feeling.
Those types of things, you can't put a price tag on that, and you can only get it into a smaller environment such as Ida Crown.
I first met George Lennon when we were in fifth grade together. He moved from the South Side. Julie came about a year later. We were all students in elementary school together at Hillel Torah, and we all came to the Academy together.
They always went to one another about their boy problems, girl problems. They were friends, but that's the best basis, I guess, for any relationship is friendship.
They've grown up together.
and their families have grown up together, and they work as a team, they're partners.
Their commitment to the school has continued. You feel the compassion, you feel the care. They're always looking out for others. And I think the Academy will always play an important part of their life.
George and Julie embody the mitos, tovos, that are transmitted at Ida Crown. Their love for Torah, for Yiddishkeit, Ahavas Yisroel, and their love of people.
They see the benefit. I mean, they have kids who are all exemplifying exactly the kind of goals that the Academy has stressed. And that's not just to the credit of the Academy, it's also, of course, credit to George and Julie and the environment that they raise their children in.
Their kids are the way that they are because George and Julie have been so supportive of their different interests and what they've chosen to do in life. It's an important value of the Academy to make sure that whoever you are, wherever you come from, you have a home here at the school where you can explore and figure out what's right for you.
The Academy and my parents both taught me about the importance of true friendship and family and having true emunah in Hashem.
I wouldn't be living here in Israel if it wasn't for going to the Academy. It was super cool for my parents that we all went to the same middle school and high school as them. We're carrying out the legacy, so it's a really big part of their lives.
Supporting a Jewish education is very tough. They worked very hard to put us into Ida Crown, and now that we're a little older, we really understand how important that was to create a nice bond with the community, also just sharing a lot of the same experiences that they did.
It's not just about necessarily learning Chumash or Navi, but it's a base for a great life. So if I am half the parents that my parents were, I'd be ecstatic.
I just wanted to say Mazel Tov, I love you guys, and we're so proud of you.
You know, everyone has busy lives, but some people find time to be even more involved than it seems possible that they can be, and that's George and Julie.
Both of them were leaders within our chevra, within our class. And both of them continue to be people that we look up to. Great balabatim, extraordinary parents, and just really good friends.
When you're in an environment like the Academy, it's not just the learning, the formal learning, but it's all those informal things that happen that it becomes an educational opportunity.
My whole outlook on Judaism and all of those values just came out from everything that I learned from my days at Hillel Torah and my days at Ida Crown. Ida Crown was absolutely the best years of my life. And I just loved everything about it. And to me, it was family, community, and diversity. And to this day, they're my best friends, including this one right here.
Oh.
Someone lower the baskets a little bit here. That's the Academy I remember. George and I want everybody to know that we're taking on all challengers 2-on-2 half-court games right after the dinner. If you're over 50. I'm very moved to be here tonight to participate in this beautiful banquet and to make the presentation to my very dear friends, George and Julie. During the 40th year since our graduation in 1976, 40 years ago, and what a beautiful class it was, I want to extend my Hakoras HaTov to the Academy, to our Rebbeim and our teachers for the chinuch and the hadracha that they gave us, for the very strong friendships that remain to this very day,
I want to salute our classmate and our good friend, Rabbi Lenny Mitenki, who steers this glorious ship in a masterful way, Mehayo Lohoyo. And I do want to make mention of four people who I remember with a lot of love, Mr. and Mrs. Lennon and Mr. and Mrs. Nathan, the parents of George and Julie, who were true role models for me during my years in high school. George and Julie, you're beautiful people, you are a beautiful couple, and you've raised a beautiful family. George, with your warmth and your goodness, which runs through you, Toko Kabaro. Julie, with your exuberance and your vitality and your great sense of humor. Together you share something very dear, and that is a golden heart, which is rooted in Torah, Chesed, teaching, Ma'asim Tovim, friendship, and serving Klal Yisroel. May Hashem Yisborach bless you always with nachas from your family and from all that you do. La'orach yamim tovim. Thank you, Rosa. Julie and George Lennon, alumni of the year, class of 1976. Dr. Edward A. Crown Scholarship Dinner, Ida Crown Jewish Academy. Chof Zayin Shvat, 5777, February 22nd, 2017. Mazel
Chairman did such an outstanding job. It's truly an honor for Julie, both Julie and I, to be here tonight. Mazel tov to Julie and Steve Grant, parents of the year, and to Ms. Sennett, educator of the year, who taught all five of our children as part of her illustrious career at Ida Crown. It's also truly an honor for both Julie and I to share this day in memory of our dear classmate, Tammy Kaplan, Zichron Alibrafa. As the Kaplan family has established a Dr. Tammy Kaplan College Guidance Program in her memory, and I'm sure this program will be put to good use for many years to come. On behalf of Julie and myself, I'd like to give a Hakaras HaTov to Hashem for bringing us to this point in our lives. Also to our parents, Irving and Pearl, Nathan and Hale and Shirley Lennon, Zichron Alibrafa, for having the commitment to Judaism and foresight to send both Julie and myself to Jewish day schools, and specifically tonight, Ida Crown Jewish Academy. We don't know where we would be today without the incredible Jewish foundation and education that we received along the way. To our five beautiful children and their spouses, we love you more than words can say and are so proud of all of you. Ida Crown truly played such an integral part of our development. In these 4 years, contained some of the most memorable experiences in our lives, and we were so fortunate to have spent them together at Ida Crown. The Crown Family, Jewish Federation, ATT, and all of those people, too many to mention tonight, who have spent countless and tireless hours making this dream come true, mazel tov, and you must be so proud, and rightfully so. Words cannot do justice to our appreciation for these efforts to our entire community. Menachem and Bracha, We cannot thank you enough for making this effort to come to Chicago. It was so meaningful to have you here tonight, presenting us with this award. You have both played such an integral role in our lives, and we are so privileged to have you as two of our closest friends. Rabbi Batenki was the first person that Lori and I met when we moved from the South Side, as he and Bobby rode over on their bicycles all the way across the street. Then Barry Mendelsberg was next, and we have been such close friends ever since. And this is what happens in the Ida Crown family, incredible close friendships. I could go on and on thanking so many people from the Ida Crown family, both teachers, coaches, and friends who've impacted our lives in so many ways. However, to save time, I will just say, class of 76, this award is all for you. Thank you for all of you coming tonight. We truly live in an incredible community. May Hashem bless all of you with only good health and happiness, and may we all continue to celebrate Simchas together in the future.
It is not a coincidence that we are using this chazan stand tonight. Deva and Jane, in adding every meaningful touch to tonight's dinner, had it brought from the Beit Midrash, where it is kept and used on a daily basis. It reads, in memory of Bernice and Daniel Fagan and Ernest Kaplan, donated by Tammy and Edward Kaplan and family. Tammy and I met in freshman English class. It must have been Bashir, since this is the only class we had together in 4 years at ICJA. We both joined the Young Drama Club, and after our one and only performance, discovered that we had no talent at acting, but great talent at being friends. We went on to become college roommates, bridesmaids at each other's weddings, and lifelong friends. I am honored to give a short tribute to my dear friend, and then introduce a video about her. Tammy enjoys seeing her kids make academy friends and memories also. They weren't always happy ones. How long did Tammy agonize over whether it was really okay for Mike and his friends to drive cross country in an old school bus? When Tammy felt something was missing, academically or otherwise, from Mike, Michelle, or Ben's academy experience, she never failed to act upon it and really tried her best to make it better, even if it meant irritating her ex-classmate, who happened to be the principal. If you didn't know Tammy, picture someone spirited and opinionated, a presence wherever she went, beautiful on the inside and out, caring and generous, never afraid or hesitant to get involved or go out of her way to help someone, passionate and outspoken about what she believed in. Tammy was going to the APAC conference and writing letters for camera even before most of us had even heard of these organizations. She was a doctor by profession, but her greatest joy was being a wife and mother. The Kaplan home became a second home to their kids' ICJA classmates, who were welcomed and loved week after week, month after month, and year after year. There were times during the last year that Tammy would come home from the hospital so weak, just in time for Shabbat, only to be greeted by a houseful of Ben's friends sleeping over. I couldn't understand why Tammy would choose to have these guests when she needed to rest. She told me from the heart how much it meant to her to see that each boy, no matter what community he lived in, would have a joyful and social and beautiful Shabbat. She later told me that one of the things that brought her comfort was hearing the beautiful smirot that these boys would sing around her Shabbat table. Strong in her faith in Hashem, even when it was challenged. It is not always for us to understand God's ways. I would much rather not be standing here today, but instead sitting at one of these tables next to Tammy, talking, giggling, and sharing the details of our lives, all while supporting the academy that we both love. I missed her phone call today. What are you wearing? What time are you getting there? Do you think we'll be at the same table? Her memory will be with us always. And now, please direct your attention to the screens for a short video.
Honoring Tammy is beyond deserving. To watch her through these last years, there is no stronger person, that I know. And I love her and I will miss her.
She was definitely an inspiration. She had a lot of courage. She never dwelt on her own issues. She was always trying to help other people and reach out to other people. She was a straight person. She said it like it was, but she was always respectful of everybody.
One of those rare individuals who spread light and joy with wonderful memories of who and what she was.
I think that Tammy's main focus was her kids. She was very strong in her faith and her belief and her love of her people, committed to her children's growth and to their development of love for Judaism and their people and Israel, was to make sure that they went in the right path.
When Tammy passed away, it wasn't just her family that was in shock. It was a community who depended on her to keep us on the straight and narrow, and depended on her to keep smiling and encouraging, and depended on her to make sure that we would live up to be the best that we can be.
You know, Tammy was always the first one where it was my birthday, she was the first one to come with a present and I wish you congratulations, and just treat every member of your family like they were royalty. And she really did care. She didn't just hear the problem, she'd make phone calls and she would do things and she would go to any extent. It was an honor. I honestly was so fortunate to have a friend like Tammy.
What moved her was a strong belief that what, however things were, they could be better. Part of that was an importance of a good, strong school, and she had enough opinions, having been a student here, having been a mother here, that she thought she could help and felt that that was necessary, not only for her children, but for the future generations that would come through this school.
The very fact that we're naming our college guidance department after Tammy is a testament to how she believes so strongly in the importance of a college prep education at the Academy, how much she believed we could accomplish, and with her help, how much we did accomplish.
I think Tammy Kaplan embodied what it meant to be a modern Orthodox Jew, Torah Umada. She was strong in her beliefs and value system, passing it down to her children, and yet she was out in the medical field helping humanity.
My mother loved that the Academy provided her a sense of community. The school was involved with each and every child, and she made sure that we all gained a lot from it also.
The college guidance that she provided us as kids to supplement what we were lacking is something that she really believed should be in place here, so that, because, you know, she always said, you know, one day if I'm not around, how are you guys gonna do X, Y, and Z? And so I think it's befitting.
Education was always really important to my mom because she would always say that no one can take it away from you. She realized Ida Crown is preparing a current and future generation of movers and shakers. Just smart kids are coming out of here, and she just wanted them to have the best resources and options available because she was just like, this school is incredible and these kids can go on to do incredible things.
This just seemed to embody her belief that the kids needed to be able to reach their potential in the best schools possible, and with that bring their strength in Judaism to face the rest of the world.
Jewish Academy is honored to establish the Dr. Tammy Kaplan College Guidance Program, Dr. Edward A. Crown Scholarship Dinner, February 22nd, 2017, 27th of Shvat, 5777.
31 seconds to say thank you. I'll do that. Before I do, though, this is just an incredible tribute. I want to thank everybody. And some things that they said were true. I have Tammy's phone, and once in a while, things pop up with someone's birthday who I've never heard of. They did keep track of all that. So our family wishes to express our gratitude to Rabbi Matenki, Allison, Diva, Jane Best, and all the others involved in putting this wonderful evening together. We thank Ida Crown for this very touching tribute, and hopefully noticeable benefits will be seen in short order from this effort. We are also extremely appreciative of friends and family that came here tonight to show support. The kids and I also want to take this opportunity to publicly acknowledge and thank the community for the incredible support and show of Abba, Achim, and Chesed to our family during this past most challenging year. One of Tammy's passions began with her tireless advocating for our kids in preparation for college and their futures. But then she took what she learned to help others going through the same process. She sounded like a college advisor herself with the numerous conversations and phone calls she had with other parents and students. Tammy's dream was that Ida Crown would have the reputation of being the premier place to get college advice. Despite very limited resources, Ida Crown, and especially Rabbi Fliegelman, has made great strides in the last few years in college guidance and advisement. It is our hope that this will sustain and augment that momentum. Thank you.
Mazel tov again to all the honorees, and thank you all for joining us tonight. Thank you to Danziger Caterers for providing us with the dessert buffet, which is located in the Math Science Commons after the dinner. There are signs directing you outside. If you have bid on any of the auction items or participated in the raffle, please check the boards on your way out to see if you have won, and you can pick up your prizes at the front desk as you leave. We will also be davening Maariv in the Beit Midrash, and the rabbi will now lead us in the benching. Thank you.